Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Fruitek. Last time Google had finally made available Android 16 beta 3 for eligible Pixel devices. Google already uploaded its in-depth review and made available its ported GSI for all the devices. So non-Pixel devices like my OnePlus 9RT and others can enjoy the new Android 16. You can check the video link given in iCard for detailed review of that build. But Google again started to roll out their new Android 16 Beta 3.1 for Pixel 6, 7, 8 and 9 series, who again got the ported build of this update from the Pixel 6 device, and it's ported on my OnePlus 9RT. So if you are a fan of Pixel devices, then you can enjoy the features, look and the performance of Android 16 Beta 3.1 on any device. So I divided this video in a three different timeline. One is what's new we got in this Android 16 beta 3.1. Second, if you install this build, what's new features do you get? And at the last, I shown what's working and the minor bugs of this ported GSI build. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted this ported GSI build on my OnePlus 9RT using the DS loader on non-Pixel devices, which has ARM64AB dynamic system with the treble support, can flash and test this build on their devices. Its installation video link is given in iCard video. Let's jump to the about device details of new Android 16 beta 3.1. So basically nothing has been changed in this build in comparison with the old beta 3.0. Android version and the Easter egg is same with the new auto mode of driving your spaceship in the Easter egg. Security patches are the same of December 2024. Except that other things like kernel, build number will remain same like your stock primary ROM. But the build number in the QS panel is updated to the new A16AP3A240617.008. The major overall of this update is its smoothest performance. Apps opening, closing, scrolling, switching between applications and the touch response is absolutely buttery smooth as compared to the old Android version beta 3.0 and any older Android version I tested till the date. Except the two major changes, there is nothing new in this update. The first one is under the display and the touch option, who gets the toggle for screen timeout called as the adaptive time, which will automatically turn off the display if you are not using your device for a while. Except this second feature is added by the Google, but it's not available for this ported build and it's also not available for the Pixel 6 devices. I will show you that in the bugs timeline. Non-Pixel device users, what features you will get if you are thinking to try this build? As this is a ported stock ROM from the Pixel 6 device, you will get the new features of the Pixel like its widgets of clock, weather, Google Photos, all are working great. Even the battery widget is properly working, which shows the device and other connected devices battery percentage on the home screen. By using this, you can directly jump into the settings of the connected devices. You will get the pure Pixel device look with the decent material you designed for the volume slider, QS and the settings panel. Who gets all the Pixel device exclusive features like Circle to Search, Google Gemini, Now Playing, etc. Latest Pixel launcher is available in this build, so you can quickly copy or share any content like text, images, web pages links directly within the recents panel of the Pixel launcher. Now let's talk about what's working. For me on my OnePlus 9RT, most of the things are working like Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi hotspot, Bluetooth devices with the audio, GPS, etc. All the sensors are working like accelerometer, light, proximity, magnetometer, compass, gyroscope, etc. Other important things like vibration, fast charging, ear proximity, microphone, ear speakers, display are working great in this build. But there are some major issues I got for this build in my device, like 4G, 5G networks are working with the incoming and outgoing calls, but I can't able to get any audio while on the calls even though the ear speaker is working. No fingerprint sensor is working, face unlock setting is available but you can't able to set it. So you need to use only pattern unlock for the unlocking your device. No Google Photos unlimited backup is available. but it was working for old ported ROM we tested in the previous video. Camera punch hole and the status bar icons make it misaligned, but it's not a deal breaking issue. Google Play integrity checks are failing and the device Play Protect is not certified in this build. So you may face issues while using some applications, specifically for the banking and the payment applications. But in my OnePlus 9T, I am successfully able to use WhatsApp, all the payment and the banking applications, even though these checks are failing. New feature of screen of fingerprint unlock is not available in the security setting. Remember, this is a ported JSR ROM, so it may have different bugs for the different devices. So don't complain, this is not working for me and you've shown it's working in video. So you have to test all of these things by yourself. Simple way to test this build, use DS loader. If you think this pixel port is enough stable to use as a daily driver, later you can flash it via TWRP by using the fastboot as a permanent ROM. Or you can still dual boot it using the DS loader along with your stock primary ROM. So this is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.